Hello, today I'm going to be showing you how to use the GoPro editing software.
Adorama TV presents Capture the Action with Martin Dorey.
Hello, I'm Martin Dorey and you are watching Adorama TV. I'm in the rather salubrious office today and I'm going to be showing you how to cut your GoPro footage using the editing software from GoPro. Now, GoPro Studio is free to download, although you will have to check that your system is up to it because it requires a huge amount of memory and processing power. Now, once you've downloaded the software, the first thing you need to do is to get your footage that you've shot on your GoPro and get it onto your system. You do that by connecting up your USB cable, plugging it into your PC, and then your GoPro will appear as if it's an extra drive on your computer. You can then swap your files over to a different folder and then start uploading them. So what I'm gonna do now is just copy them across to the new folder on my computer, which means I can work off them from my computer because it's more stable than working off the files from the camera. Also, it means that I can delete the files from my camera and the SD card will be free to use on another shoot. And this is going to take some time, so I'm going to go and put the kettle on. Okay, so once you've copied your files over, you need to open up GoPro Studio. And once GoPro Studio is opened up, you can then import your files from your hard drive using this column here. You would choose the folder that you've left your files in and then double click on a file and it will then appear. You can now play that file like that and you can also trim the file. Now also, if you wanted to change the speed, you have got advanced settings here which allow you to change the speed, the size of the image, the quality, and also the file type. So you can do an awful lot at this stage, but we don't actually need to do much. If I wanted to trim a clip, all I have to do is choose the start point and choose the end point. Now, if the clip is that long, I've chosen that section. What I'm now going to do is add this to my conversion list. Now, converting a file means that you're converting it into the file type that GoPro Studio can edit. So it goes onto my conversion list, and then I will convert that later on. What I do next is just choose more files. And so it goes on. Look, the footage is looking great now. So what I've done is I've trimmed and I've added everything to the conversion list. The next stage is to convert everything into a usable format. That's the time to click convert all and go and make another cup of tea because it will take a while. Okay, great. Looks like all my clips have been converted and I will now proceed to step two as it says here. Okay, at this point I've got a choice of choosing an edit template. Now, it will make films for you if you want it to, but for this purposes of this exercise, I'm actually going to use a blank template. So I click on that and create it, and now I've got the ability to create whatever I want. You'll see the clips that I've imported will now appear on the left-hand side, and in order to put them onto the film timeline, which runs along here, all I have to do is drag them down there. And then I can trim them, play them, cut them, and control them using all the controls on the right-hand side. But we'll talk about that in a minute. Right, so all I'm gonna do today is make a rough montage of the footage against a music track. The first thing I need to do is import my music. Now, I can do that very easily by clicking on Media, choosing the track I want to use, and that will appear here in my uploaded clips track. And what I'm going to do is then drag that over onto the timeline and it will then play. Right, so what I'm going to start doing now is constructing my film by dragging the clips onto the timeline. I do this by clicking, holding, and dragging them onto the timeline. Now, what I'm going to do is create a rough assemble edit. So that means I'm going to have my shots in the right order, but not necessarily trimmed to the right length, because I can do that later on. Now, the idea is that we get all the shots in the right order. If you decide that you haven't got a shot in the right order and you want to move around, you can easily do that. I'm going to insert the key turning in the ignition slot and place it there, because that's actually in the right order. Okay, so once I've made my rough assembly, it's time to start thinking about doing a fine cut. Now, that's when you trim all your shots to length. As you can see at the moment, they're all far too long. So I'm going to trim them all to the right length, and then we should start to feel like a film's coming together. Right, let's take a quick look at the right-hand side of the screen now. Now, this is the control panel. This controls your shots. This is where you can alter your exposure, the speed of your shots, the sound levels of your shots. You can alter the white balance, and you can also alter the exposure. So say, for example, I wanted to alter the exposure of this shot. All I have to do is drag the slider up and down. As you can see, it's very, very easy. There are also a whole bunch of presets with the GoPro Studio, and you can get certain film looks if you want them. For example, they call this their 1970s look, which is a bit kind of warm, and it's supposed to be a bit like a kind of warm film look. And you can choose any number of these. You've got a bit of vignetting on this one, sepia if I wanted to make it look old-fashioned, like it's night vision, and so on and so forth. So you can choose any of those presets. For this film, I'm going to keep it straight. Look, what I've done is I've shot something, okay? I've imported it from my GoPro camera into GoPro Studio. I've chosen the files I want to use, I've trimmed them to length, and I have converted them to a format AVI that GoPro Studio can use to edit, and I have created a rough assembly, and then I've gone and fine-tuned it. Now, I'm pretty happy with where we've got to there. What I need to do now is export it so that I can use it on YouTube, Facebook, or wherever. Okay, so the only decision you need to make at this stage is what file size you want to export your film at. Now, everything's there for you. Again, with GoPro Studio, it's very easy. There are a number of presets that you can choose. I optimize for YouTube, for Vimeo, for a mobile device, or even you can choose your own custom edit. And if you're shooting and editing at 4K, it will export it at that size. And you can see also when you select one, the size of the file that your final video will be. And that may have some bearing on what you do. Okay, for this edit, I'm going to choose to export it for YouTube. I click export, I choose the folder I want it to go in, and away it goes. And it's as easy as that. Next stop, Hollywood. Right, that's it, brilliant. What a lot of fun that is. Okay, thank you for joining me on Adorama TV today. Don't forget you can go to the Learning Center for more great hints and tips. And also, don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV for more great videos. Finally, please, if you like this video, like it, comment, or share. And if you want to know anything, just get in touch. See you next time.
you want great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.